The five women were part of a group of 19 people arraigned in court in the aftermath of bomb attacks at Parliamentary Avenue and Kampala Central Police Station in November 2021. After several months of inquiries into their case, the state found no substantial evidence to pin them.
One, we have to advise our clients on the best way forward. And why do we need to advise them? Because we do not want a similar incident to happen again to other people who are incarcerated for more than 2 years and there's nothing to be done. Now, there is need and there is hope that we shall advise our clients to file a matter in civil division for the infringement of their rights. Secondly, the one for malicious prosecution. Thirdly, we have our colleagues, our clients who are still incarcerated, the boys. And there are many, there are more than 13, 14. We have to do everything possible. The best advice to the state and the best advice to also the DPP is to do the similar thing they have done to the ladies. Why? Because we are sure up to now that our clients are still innocent until proven guilty.
At that time, the state has taken you on. You've been in custody for all that time, and then at the end of the day, you're acquitted without any charges. So some people opt to sue the government for malicious prosecution, for compensation and damages for all that time lost. But all that depends on the person, really, on the client, on the individual who has been incarcerated.
In the amended charge sheet, 14 people will now battle the terrorism charges against them. They are charged with two counts of terrorism and belonging to a terrorism group.